Shalom Chavrim, I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live, and of course we are live on live stream, our Vimeo channel live stream. We are broadcasting live there. We may be doing less live stream broadcast on YouTube. We are definitely under an all-out assault and attack by different factions that are trying to suppress the truth to the rest of the world. As a result, we're trying to do a couple of different things to get things back running smoothly again, but we are definitely being attacked. We're seeing our comments disappear out of the channel. We're seeing very much of a battle to even get the live stream to work properly on YouTube. And so we realize that there is definitely some very powerful forces in the background that would like us to kind of go away. So those of you that are watching on live stream, I apologize for the quality of the broadcast. I will try to get the, actually I have my live stream broadcaster in Europe. I don't have it here with me to where we can actually run this through the camera as well. But we're going to try to get all these issues resolved very soon and get these things going for you. We do have very serious news, breaking news, different things that are happening, including Pastor Brunson has been released. It's a great thing to hear about that. Turkey finally releasing this pastor, and after what was it, almost a two-year prison sentence he's been serving there for being an alleged spy. But even more important at this moment right now is President Poroshenko, the dictator, I guess you could say, the installed puppeteer of the Ukrainian government, as the real president was actually overthrown through a Maidan coup. But Poroshenko's decision on weapons to Donbass fans tensions, according to the Kremlin. This is released on TASS news agency. But the thing is it is very obvious, even as we were reporting the other day about the special forces, and we look at this as mercenaries, you know, special forces being the fact that they have been part of special force units in the past, no doubt. But they are moving in some very heavy guns, and this is what we're seeing right now. This just came out just moments ago there. This is the six Tokyu missile system that has been deployed over on the border with Donetsk. This is a very, very powerful system. And just to kind of give you an idea of what it does, here's just a short clip of a video I'll kind of play about this. This is the missile being used and showing the capabilities of this system here. And this is no longer the 122 millimeter caliber cruise missiles or even the different types of grenade launchers, whatever they may be deploying over there on the border with the Donetsk and Luhansk Republics, the breakaway region that Russia has been helping to protect. These bombs here are going to take out targets much more powerful than anything that's been deployed in the war to date. It's just a matter of time before I'm sure that they will use air assault campaign. We have been watching regularly the buildup of forces there in Ukraine and also in the Sea of Azov, etc. It is no doubt that there are plans to retake Crimea as well. This is only going to ratchet up tensions between Russia and the United States already, as it appears to be they've been fighting pretty much head to head in different fronts, military fronts as it is. Also, Russia too unveiling the S-500, speaking about in this article right here, is a Russian article that we picked up on NovaRussia.ru, the S-500 from the defense of Russia to the global missile defense system of Eurasia. This is going to be their new system that is coming out, and it is said to be much greater, far more powerful in knocking out aircraft as well as aircraft carriers. Has the ability to do just exactly that. And so the system there that Russia now is speaking about, this system being rolled out into full production now, that will replace the S-400 system. Always makes you wonder, when Russia is willing to sell the S-400, there must be something else that they have up their sleeve that can combat what's going on. As I mentioned, though, BBC and other news have been breaking the wonderful news of Andrew Brunson, pastor that has been released from Turkey, U.S. pastor after 2 years. I don't know exactly what his plans are, if he's going to be coming back to the U.S. or not, but does say a court in Turkey has freed a U.S. pastor from house arrest in a case of badly strained ties between the U.S. and Turkey. Andrew Brunson was arrested over alleged links to political groups, including the banned Gulenist movement, after a failed coup attempt in 2016. And you know what's really, really tough, guys, is the fact that the coup in 2016 was staged to begin with. It was only used as a preemptive measure in order to be able to silence the media when Erdogan was under threat of growing media campaign that would have brought about his ouster from the government. And they could not have that happen because he is too valuable of an asset for a new world order. So that definitely could not be the case there. Jerusalem Post is also reporting on an article today. Audio and video proof of the support of the Saudi journalist was killed. And they said the Turkish government is showing they told the U.S. officials that they have the audio video recordings that corroborate with the theory of Jamal Khashoggi, a Saudi Arabian journalist, was killed in the Saudi consulate in Istanbul. We saw it when the story first broke. We haven't mentioned it as of yet. But what the allegations were is not only did the Saudis have him killed, but the Saudis also, they sawed his body up, brought a bone saw in, sawed him up, and took him out in pieces. And just goes to show what Wahhabism will do to you if they do not find you in full compliance to their ideology. And that's actually what the U.S. is backing when it comes to the Middle East and all the different war terrors that are going on in the Middle East to start with. They are working with the Saudis, the Yemen crisis, the Syrian crisis. All these crises are brought together by those different forces. And of course, a territorial mass movement by Israel claiming that all the lands between the Nile and the Euphrates River belongs to Israel. I'd have to argue that it belonged to Abraham and his descendants, which also does include part of the Israelis, the 12 tribes of Israel, not just 3 tribes. But at that token there, Moses never gave us those lands next to the Euphrates, and neither did he give us the lands next to the Nile River. But you have to remember, we are related to those people all through the areas. Ishmael's descendants as well. We know they live in these areas. We were told not to mess with Esau's children, nor were we to mess with the children of Ammon. We were not to bother with them. And we had made a covenant with Syria not to cross over to take this land. So what are we doing trying to go in there and take things that do not belong to us? And as far as the Egyptians, we see the prophecies of the Egyptians will end up believing the Messiah to a great advantage. And we also know that it was Joseph that married Asenath, an Egyptian princess. Her father was a high priest. Joseph marries her. So we have Egyptian lineage also in the region there. So, you know, it's really kind of absurd to think that we have a right to take something that does not belong to us. And we also, it's absurd to think that Israel, the modern state of Israel, under the Jewish law, has a right to take the lands that belong to the house of Israel. That's something I'm sure they wouldn't like very well for me to say, but it's the truth. Here is a mom that has done what I consider to be the greatest thing of all. A mother, for the love of her child, a 4-month-old baby, is horribly bruised, shielding her baby from softball-sized hailstones. The hailstones were busting out the window on the car, and she shielded her baby. And it shows here the very images, which just unbelievable, the bruising to this poor lady right here. Her child got hit as well, once in the head there, once in the forehead, you can see, but she immediately threw herself over the child. They show a closer-up image there of just the beating she took from these hailstones hitting her body. Unbelievable, but what a mother. I pray God will give her a speedily recovery. No harm will come to her or the child, and you know, just that's a real mother's love. I just cannot say enough for what she did. So Also, Virginia Branson halts talks on $1 billion Saudi investment in space. I'm glad to see somebody waking up to the Saudis and how evil of an empire this is. There are several politicians also doing this like manner, saying that we should stop funding to the Saudis. What did it take? I mean, did it take just one Saudi journalist to be cut up into pieces for people to begin to realize that the Saudi government's been involved in, you know, atrocities? What about Syria? What about Yemen? What about all the those that are dying over there? I guess they don't matter much, right? But you know, no, it does matter, and something should have been done much sooner than what we're seeing here. All right, guys, so we're about to wrap it up here. Just want to remind you, the conference, 49 days from now, December 2nd in Shawnee, Kansas. It is a suburb of Kansas City, Kansas there. You come to the website, conference.israelinewslive.org. Register. You want to register for this conference. We have myself, my wife, and Dr. Stephen Pidgeon will be speaking at this conference. It is a one-day conference on December 2nd, but it'll be packed from early morning all the way to late evening. You don't want to miss this. I'm telling you, there's things going to be said here that you've never heard before, and documentation that you have never seen before. We'll be getting into the money laundering, the government, the cover-ups. We'll be getting into a lot of things I've known personally from my own past. Current event situations that we know about that are happening. An admission of guilt by Israelis that also have said things there that would just blow you away. To know the things that have gone on in this world. Definitely you want to be there, Dr. Pidgeon. I'm hoping he will also be sharing with us the mega churches that have been involved in money laundering schemes as well. So go to the conference. We have our coordinators of this, Laurel Austin and Daisy Peraldi. Definitely click on this website. Go there. Reserve tickets is right here at the top. It's $25 a person. There is discounts for groups. You can just click on that. You'll find out the information on it. You want to be there. It's going to be very informative. And listen, friends, we need your help more than ever at this point in time, too, because what we are doing is trying to get the truth out to the world. And there's not many people that like hearing the truth. It is very difficult. We are being attacked on multiple fronts right now. And we're going to be sharing at the conference some of that information as well. We have documented evidence of those that are involved in behind the scenes that are trying to silence us. And you need to be aware of this. You need to be aware of the infiltrations inside the evangelical and Hebrew roots movements. You have infiltrators. We know who they are. And we will share with you that type of information. We'll talk a little bit more about the Kennedy assassination as well, how the government was in behind that. Just a wealth of information that will be shared at this conference. You want to be there. Watch for later today on Patreon, our broadcast, patreon.com/Israeli News Live. Be sharing some information there. And as well, hopefully tonight, I will be able to pull together the our Shabbat Live broadcast. Maybe we'll air it on Israeli News Live. If not, I'll try to get it over on Danun Institute. So we hope to see you all there. If you want to contribute to the broadcast, all you have to do is just type in israelinewslive.org. And looks like I always have something up here that's set up for something else here. But definitely take... And just type in, go to our website here, israelinewslive.org, and you can donate online right there on the right. If for some reason it gives you a problem not to be able to donate there, then you can always take and join us over on patreon.com/Israeli News Live. You can give there. It's not that expensive to give. You can support it however God lays it on your heart. And even if you're not always listening to Patreon, that helps support the broadcast, period. So it's just another way to be able to help support what we are doing. But we do try to share things that are a little bit more risky on that channel than taking a chance of being taken down offline on other on our other platforms that we are on. So, as well, on the broadcast here, if you're watching on Danoon Institute, you can see our mailing address. It is right there on the screen for you. At the bottom of the screen, you can check that out, and you can also help contribute in that manner as well. Thank you for watching. God bless you, and shalom, shalom, in a world of Ein Shalom. There is no peace, and I don't see any peace until the coming of the Messiah.